These are dangerous people. These are people that are taking risks every single day and making their lives exciting. You cannot make your life exciting by being comfortable and being a bitch. What's going on, everyone? I'm doing one of these other desk videos. And today I want to speak about how to be more productive, how to get your shit together every single day so that you can build a successful life and a successful lifestyle, okay? So let's get right into it. The first thing that I like to do is I like to write down the top 3 to 5 things that I have to do every single day, right? I like to simplify my life. I don't like to complicate things. If I'm walking throughout the day with all of these things in my head, trying to figure out what the next thing to do, I'm disorganized, forget about this, forget about that, because I don't have a structure. I don't have a system where I'm keeping everything on and remaining myself structured and organized. I am more likely to let other people down. I'm more likely to let myself down. I'm more likely to be scattered throughout the day and unproductive. So the whole point of this video is to be more productive. And this is one of the things that I personally do and I've been doing for the last 5 years. I write down the top 5 things that I gotta get done every single day to make sure that I'm on point, that I'm sharp. And as long as I complete that checklist, I win the day. So write down the 3 to 5 things that you have to do every single day. Now, I recommend that you do it the night before, because if you do it the night before, you're more likely to hold yourself accountable the day after, right? You're not waking up at the wrong time. You're not missing certain things that you have to do throughout the day, right? And now having to make up for it because you weren't prepared the night before. Make sure that you do it before you go to sleep. That way, the next day, you can be ready. You don't have to think about it too much. It's already there and it's just go. Which brings me to my next point. You have to have a do it now mentality, right? What is a do it now mentality? A lot of the times we could possibly allow things to just linger and say, oh, you know what? I'll do it later. I'm not really gonna take care of it now. I'm just gonna do this for now. Oh, my mom calls and I have to go do this. I gotta go run this errand. I gotta go drop this off. And it has nothing to do with the 5 critical things that you have to take care of on that day, which should get done first. And that's the point of why you wanna have a structured system where you can now take care of these 5 things and not get distracted, right? So whatever it is that you write down, you have to have a do it now mentality. You gotta make 30 calls, do it now. You gotta go to the gym, do it now. You gotta go to that appointment, do it now. You gotta make that phone call with that client that you may have that difficult conversation that you don't want to have, but you need to have to be able to continue to advance that deal forward, do it now. Whatever it is that you have to do, do it now. You got to take that cold shower, do it now. Whatever it is, do it now. Don't allow things to linger. A lot of the times we allow things to linger because we're afraid of the change or possibly getting rejected depending on what it is, right? I'm in sales, so a lot of the guys that are afraid of making the calls and they put it off, is typically because they're afraid of being rejected. They're scared of going out into the world and getting rejected from the world, from a client, from a girl, whatever it is. They're afraid of getting hurt. That's the bottom line. And the mind is ultimately trying to protect and shelter these people by doing things that keep them comfortable and keep them complacent. And that's not where you want to be. If you want to grow your life, if you want to live a monumental life with monumental experiences and hang out with the top dogs who are fucking killing it, these are dangerous people. These are people that are taking risks every single day and making their lives exciting. You cannot make your life exciting by being comfortable and being a bitch. You have to go out into the world and be willing to do the things that are hard, the things that tap you into a different level of experiences, where now you're held to a different level of standards that is gonna demand more of you as a person, which will ultimately allow you to grow and be more successful. That's why it's so important for you to have a do it now mentality, because the more things that you do every single day with urgency, with speed, the more likely you are to be successful. And the third thing, and this is something that I've been applying recently more than ever, is sleep. Man, I used to talk so much shit about sleep. Fuck sleep, 4 to 5 hours. I don't give a fuck. Wake up the next day, do my shit. I was doing 2 workouts a day with 4 to 5 hours of fucking sleep. and that wasn't healthy. I was pushing through it, but eventually I got a concussion because I was tired. And I was more likely to get injured because my body wasn't recovering properly because I was lacking sleep, right? So one of the things that has helped me tremendously with my energy levels and being effective and productive is giving myself the 7 to 9 hours of sleep the day before, so that way when I wake up, I'm fucking ready to go. It's like you have a car, right? And you fill it up just enough to get on the road and drive to your destination. You're gonna have to continuously keep making stops. And God forbid your car breaks down, now you're gonna waste another hour or 2 hours waiting for somebody to come fill you up so that then you could go ahead and continue to your destination. Why not fill up your gas tank before you leave so that you can reach your destination in a full go, so that you can be as efficient, as effective, and as productive throughout the whole day so that you don't have to make these stops. You don't have to allow any inconveniences and any unnecessary obstacles because the road of success is already challenging. Why welcome other obstacles that are going to carry you to a direction where it could potentially put your success at risk? Allow the challenges that are already there to be there and don't welcome any other ones because that's only gonna make your life more difficult. Instead, get on the fucking road. Before you get on the road, fill up your tank 100% and then get on that fucking road and be a fucking beast. Tackle it at 100% and get to your destination. Don't make these little pit stops, right? Like all these other guys do. Oh, I gotta get a snack. I gotta get this. I gotta get that. And then they end up getting to their destination late. Everybody's already there. They already missed out on the opportunity. And now everybody's already going for the next big thing and you're stuck behind, right? What was cool yesterday is not cool today. So you better get there faster because the faster that you get there, the more successful you will be and the bigger mountains that you'll be able to attack because you'll allow yourself more time to do it, right? It's actually the opposite. The more sleep that you get, the more effective, the more productive, and the more impactful you will be. I gotta go.
I'm back to balling, I've been on the low. Yeah, a couple $1 million just made off the road. Nah, I ain't from the D, but this shit on the flow. Yeah. Any niggas, they can't fuck with me. Wanna give a shout out to my Nina, yeah, she stuck with me. You can go ask any one of these hoes, it ain't no cuffing me. Mr. Glock, Mr. Get Shit Done, and I'm sucker free, bitch.